Very good afternoon to all of you and welcome back to the session SQL module of PGP batch. Very good afternoon to all of you. What happened? Today very few students were joined till now. Rahul, Sneha, Kavya, Raghav, Priyo, Rashmi, Dharani, Cyril, Supriya, Sriratan, Kartik, Shweta. Good morning to all of you. Anupriya, good morning. Sorry, good afternoon. I'm so sorry. Good afternoon. Sushma, good afternoon. Neha, good afternoon. Satya, good afternoon. Divya, Ritvika. Very good afternoon to all of you. So now let us start our session with a positive note that we will complete the fourth chapter and just the idea about fifth chapter also I am going to give you the idea. So what topics we were left, main topics were finished, very few topics were left over and every point by point I am not going to teach, it's you who need to learn some topics, main topics and main demos I am going to show you, okay. In this, let me share my desktop and I have kept a notepad to just give you the idea what topics were left over which we were not covered. Okay. Is it visible? Let me check. Just few seconds, it's getting displayed for you. So these are the topics, but this topic is already finished for us, okay? But the words I was not used in your while teaching in the last session. So we have learnt already primary key constraints, which will ensure that there are no duplicates and null values are allowed into the column. That type of constraint, if you are applying on any column, that is called as entity integrity. Entity integrity means nothing but applying a primary key on a particular column in a table. So that is entity integrity. And domain integrity is nothing but on some of the columns like salary, it is checked in the between 5000 and 50000 like that, or check gender in MRF. What are these? That is called as check constraints. Whenever you are applying, it is called as domain integrity. These values are only allowed in this column. Other than these values, nothing is allowed. This is to specify that, that is called as domain integrity. And referential integrity is nothing but referencing the value. A column is referencing another column, that is foreign key. The column which is the dependent column is the foreign key. And which depends on some other column is the primary key. So that type of applying primary key foreign key relationship among the table columns is called as referential integrity. And other than these three, we can create some rules on our own. Today, in today's session we are seeing. So such type of rules if you are creating on any column, other than primary key, foreign key, check constraint, default, other than these, if you create any your own rules and applying on the columns, excluding these primary key, foreign key, check constraints, some extra, you can create your own rule and apply on the columns. That type of integrity is called as user-defined integrity. So we are going to learn that itself now. And now, before to that, a small, I am not going to show you, I will show you that also. In last class, we were created some tables, am I right? And after creating the tables, if that means with the constraints we created tables. After creating tables, if you are giving invalid data, it is not accepting, right? And the gender column other than M or F, any other value if you are giving, it is not accepting. But certain times, I don't want to remove the constraint on the gender column, but temporarily it should be Disabled. What to be disabled? Constrained. You have created CHK gender constraint on the EMP personal table. So that constraint to be disabled for some time. So that now if I am adding any value in the gender column other than MRF, it should not say error. Because you have disabled the constraint, it is not having any condition on that. But after some time, again you can re-enable the constraint. You did not delete it, you just disabled. Once again you are enabling the constraint. That is only with the two keywords, no check, check. With no check, what will happen? You are disabling the constraint. With the check keyword, you are re-enabling the constraint. So I will show you one example in the EMP personal one table, adding a record. While adding a record, wantedly I will give gender value other than MRF, it will not accept. Then I will disable the your constraint and I will try to add the record, it will accept. Later, I will again re-enable it and try to insert a record by violating gender check constraint. So it will not accept. Okay, by default it is enabled after creating the constraint. Now I can any constraint, okay? You can disable and enable anytime. The command has also table name. No check means you are disabling. Check means you are enabling. With constraint means. Very simple syntax. So let us go to our one. And let us go to our database use. What is that we created? QGIS DB1. This database, select star from EMP personal one. So one record, now I will try to insert another record, okay? Insert into EMP personal one, values, 2 comma, Ramesh comma, me at @niit.com. Mail, mattress status M. Achacha, mail place X I'll give, gender value X I gave, mattress status M, and mobile number, some value for the mobile number. Here the problem is, you will get the string, okay, string would be, okay, this is more than 10 characters, that's the problem. R, one, okay, now it is okay. Now we see gender check, gender check constraint is not accepting your value X. You can check once again records of this table, this record was not inserted into your table. Because it is violating the rule. So I am just disabling the constraint CHK gender constraint. Okay, how to do it? Alter table name is EMP personal one. Okay, no check is the keyword. No check which constraint CHK gender. Finish. Select it and press F5. So it's done. Now previously whatever this is the error. Okay. Now the same statement you give it, whether it works or not, we'll see. Previously it is not adding. But now we'll check. Is it adding the record or not? One row affected. For what reason you disabled the check constant? So it is able to take the invalid value. Any value it is able to take it into that column. So now you see here the record got inserted. Now you want to, again after some time I want to re-enable the constraint. So what I can do, that is disabling, and this is success. Actually this command will be success because you have disabled. Now you want to enable the constraint. How do you enable the constraint? Say alter table EMP personal one, check, in place of no check, check constraint CHK gender. which is re-enabling. Email, ah, yes, email more than 10. Thank you so much, Divya. Yes, correct. That's why I identified and done. So don't think that it is wrong. There is nothing wrong. Once again, that's a temporary memory problem. So you see here, it go enable. Okay, that is my system memory problem. So is that clear or do you have any doubts? Anyone is having doubts? If you have the doubts, please write. Clear, Divya, great. Any doubts, please write. Jagdale Chetan, no doubt. Can you scroll up? Why not, Karthik? So previously, when I have done this command, it's an error because gender is X and I have disabled the check constraint CHK gender. Then I am doing the same insert statement, it is success and it has taken X. And then again I am enabling and afterwards you create one more, add one more record with a different EMP ID, but give the value as X. Other than MRF, anything you give it in the gender column, it will tell that it is a CHK gender violation. Can we do this with any? Yes, that's what I'm telling. I have already told you, Akshay. Not only for check constraint, it can be on any column, okay, on any constraint. Okay, it might be foreign key constraint like that, you do it. But maximum people will not do on foreign key. Why? Because later, if you enable also the values that are there are not allowed values. So that you don't do it. Just I have given like this. So enabling, disabling is over. Now, what is the rule? Very, very important, all of you. Simple also. Real rule creation. What is the rule is the question. Rule is, at what time this rule is required? Let me give you idea. I want to create four tables. Okay. Otherwise, two tables I want to create. Inter 1, inter 2. Okay. Inter 1, inter 2. The structure in both the tables is same. First table should consist of the details of the first year inter student data. Second table inter 2 should consist of the details of the students of inter 2, second inter. So I don't want to maintain single table, I want to maintain separate tables. The structure is same. Structure means here also roll number, name column, maths, physics, chemistry column, total column, average, result. These are the same columns I want. There are some rules I want to apply. On max of both the inter 1, inter 2 tables, I want to apply in such a way that whatever integer value you are entering should be in between 0 to 150. Because max marks, physics, chemistry. Max was conducted out of 150 means max will be in between 0 to 150. So if I normally take it as integer, it may take 200. If you do it also, it will take. Computer doesn't have brain that max should take only 0 to 150. As per the data type, it has to. It should take 200 also. Show the X name previous. It is showing no, my dear. Why it will not show? It will show. You have not checked Govin. Why it will not show? Okay, your answer is cleared. Now come back to this place rule. So in both the tables on max, same rule I want to apply. Check constraint I want to create in such a way that it should allow the values in between 0 to 150. So whatever check constraint you created on the max column of the inter 1 will not be reusable by max column of inter 2. So once again, while creating inter 2, I have to specify the same rule. And here math, physics and chemistry 0 to 60. Here also physics and chemistry 0 to 60. But check constraint 100% you need to create again and again. Even same table physics and chemistry, check constraint both the times I need to write. Even though 0 to 60 same check constraint, I cannot use single time writing and use it on two columns. It's a time waste. Like that multiple tables are there. In all the tables, on some columns, same constraint I want to apply. Same constraint with the same rule. then why should I create those many times is the question. That time rule will help you. So you create one rule and you can apply that rule on any table, any column of any table, on any column of any table. So you are creating rule once, but you can bind this rule, that means link this rule on any column of any table of your database. So that will help you out. So for that reason, we are going to create a rule. So what are the, there are two rules I'll create, rule one, rule two. Rule one is check constants between 0 to 150. Second rule is it is 0 to 60. Two check constants with two rules. How to create a rule? Creating a rule. Okay. Creating a rule. And before creating a rule, my dear, let me create some table, two tables. Create enter one. Without any condition, don't use any constraints. Okay. Directly you write. Things so that roll number int. Primary key. Madam, primary key directly wrote constant, constant name. It is not mandatory, I said. If you don't write, system will write some, constant name. But very lengthy. That also I want to show you. That's why I'm not writing constant my own name. Roll number, name, where care of, 20. Okay. Not null. And max physics chemistry, max is of int or tiny int. It's of tiny int. And I'm not giving any condition on that. Physics, tiny int. Chemistry, tiny int. So total int. Okay. And computed column also I want to give you the answer. So here 1 minute. Computed column, 1/2 minute. So one extra one also I want to tell you what you mean by computed column, you will understand. Okay, just give me a minute of time. Syntax I forgot, I'll just give you idea. With the as keyword it will be there. Syntax I forgot one, so I'm just checking. No, correct. Correct, correct. So now better you take it as int only. Why not tiny int, I'll tell you later. So don't give some data types for a total, don't give any data type, this is a computer column. As, what is the max plus, physics plus, chemistry. So this is called as computed column, okay, this is called as what, computed column. So we don't require to calculate the value for that. So this is the first table where I did not provide any condition, any constraint I was not given. Yeah, very good, small int. You are good, Balmukun. Very good, my dear. Okay, small int. So this is the one, you execute it and create the enter one table. Enter one, use create drop. Sorry, what is the syntax? Create table word. Table word is missing. Table word is missing, okay. First table created, just copy paste and I'll change the table name as enter 2. Okay. I just change it as enter 2. F5. So two tables are created without any constraints. But I want constraints on math, physics, chemistry. So creating a rule for that, so two rules I'm creating. Why two rules? Not for number of tables, you don't think. Number of rules that I require. Create rule, rule name is rule 1 as, okay, otherwise max rule as, okay, as, condition you can write as, no, at the rate is mandatory, why later, any name here, call name or what, max column, I'll just give, Any name you can give. Any name it is. What you, it will be replaced by your column name. It will be replaced by your column name. When this rule you are applying on any column, this @marks is replaced by your column name of the table. That's the reason it can be any name, replaced one. On this, as @marks, somewhere some create rule name as @marks between 0 and 150. Let me check. This is correct or not? It's correct. Syntactic 100%. Syntactically it is correct. And the second rule is science rules. Let me give it a science rule. And it is in between 0 to 60. So create rule, science rule as, so these two rules is created. Creating rules no use. These rules to be bound, that means attached on your column. To apply these rules on your any table, any column. So how do you now, rules you created, how binding a rule to a column of a table. You created rules only once, am I right? Now you see here, there's a predefined command sp_bind_rule. Bind rule will bind a rule to a column. What is your rule name? Max rule. You write it as max rule, comma. On which you want to apply your table name, you write. What is your table name, my dear? Enter one. Enter one dot max column. That's it. Finish. Select it and press F5. Rule bound to the column name. That means it is bound. Again, you give the same. To apply the same rule on max column of the enter 2. So give just enter 2 and give. So rule got created once, but it is the rule can be applied on any column of any table. Okay. So second rule applied. Now enter 1 on physics column. Rule is science rule. Science rule to be applied on this file. Science rule enter 2. F5. Science rule enter 1 chemistry. Science rule on enter 2. And that person, now you observe, Akshay, I have applied the rules on max. Max rule is applied on max column of both enter 1 and enter 2 tables. Now you try to give the values into that. And one more thing, my dear, computed column, you are not allowed to specify the values. So you try to insert into enter 1 values. You give the value roll number 1. Okay, Kiran. Max marks 156. Once only you give it as 156. Generally, as per that is allowed. But as per the max rule, it is not allowed. So it should give the error. Think so that 76, this is also wrong. 56, this is okay. And don't give the value for the computed column and select and press execution. Values is spelling wrong. Sorry. Values is spelling wrong. So now you observe the statement conflicts with the rule imposed by the create rule. Are you understanding that means it is not allowing the rule violation? Little confusion in the syntax of the rule creation or rule binding. Rule creation is what now? Now I am telling creation of the rule time, create rule, max rule as @marks, it can be any name I said, right? Between zero. Whenever you are binding like that, remember this whatever column you are selecting, that is going to come in the place of @marks. So on enter, the enter one table max column, max column should hold values between 0 and 150 only. Now, Divya, understanding, create rule, rule name time, any column on which column you are going to bind that column name. That column name, no need to write. Anything you write, it will be replaced by the column name on which you are binding this rule. So that column value should be in between 0 and 150, I said. Okay. What if we don't replace the column name? What is it? How can you give like that, my dear? This is a temporary name. I'm telling that on which this rule, on which column you are applying, that column name should be placed here. But we don't know on which column we are going to apply. A temporary name should be given, which will be replaced by your column name. So binding time, whatever table and column you told, that means it will understand this between 0 and 150 should be applied on that column. Otherwise, how do you think so that you know on which column you want to apply this rule? No. A temporary name, that same name is replaced by, for first time when you are doing, it is replaced by max of inter 1, second time it is replaced by max of inter 2, third time it is replaced, this is the science rule, that is going to be replaced by inter 1 of physics, inter 2 of physics, inter 1 of chemistry, inter 2 of chemistry. Divya, is your doubt clear? Namrata? Namrata? Clear? Divya? Clear? Akshay, you have checked that after applying that it is not allowing the values 156. Now I will change the value as 146. Still there is a rule violation. Previous rule violation, which one was max rule violation? It's a max rule violation. See here on max column. But now, it's, which is violating? Your physics column is violating the rule. So again, physics column, you can see that physics column is violating. You make it as 46. So all the values are valid values. Now if you press F5, so it will be inserted successfully, one row inserted. Now you see the records of this table. Select the star from inter 1. Select it and press F5. See that computed column is what? So I gave the formula so that automatically this total column value, even though I am not supplying, system will calculate the sum of these three values and their places. That is the computed column. Akshay, yours is done. Govind, if we give the name of the column after at the rate, whatever you give, it will is a temporary name. It never treats it as column name. This is the place where your column name should come. So that can be anything. ABCD you give, even you can give the same max also. Address max means that is column name you are thinking. That is always will be replaced by your original column name. So their rule creation time, nobody will tell on which column you are applying. A temporary name you need to place will be replaced by your column name. Scroll up to create the tables. Huh? Computed column. Okay, Rashmi Rekha. In this table, which is, oh God, which is computed column you are asking. Can't you see the formula? It's a total column is the computed column where formula I have given. No data type is required. As and some formula if you give, it is the computed. I wrote as the comment also, no, my dear. Rashmi? I think you can be able to see this inter one table creation, Simran. Primary key, varchar, small int, the total column I have made it as a simple calculated value so that no need of any data type, simply as and formula. Rashmi, is your doubt clear? Computer column is total column. That's it, it's automatically calculated. Simran said, okay. Govind, I'm not getting your point. Is it clear for you or not? Same name. What? That name is a temporary name to be given, which gets replaced by our column name. But when? When you are given the binding condition. Clear. Okay, now After binding, so how you are disabling the constraint like that? Can I remove the link between your column and rule? I bound it, attached. Can I unbind the rule? Yes, there is a question. You can do unbinding of the rule also. See here, unbinding the rule. From next column, can we remove? On interval table, that's true, okay? And by ST underscore unbind rule is the, ST means what, stored procedure. These are all predefined ones. ST underscore unbind rule. Which rule you want to unbind, my dear? Max rule or max rule? I did not remember the name. Let me check. Max rule. Okay. On which table? Enter one table. Let me check any syntactical error I gave. Max rule does not exist, or you do. Why we did not get? Find rule. Here, what rule you want to unbind, you should not tell. On which column, from a column, whatever rule you have applied to be removed. What rule is not required to specifically, you are not supposed to tell. Just tell that in enter one table, there is a mass column, and that some rules are linked, remove those rules. Now I have removed the rule from the mass, what is applied on that mass rule, but no need to specify, if you specify it wrong. Any rule that is available on the next column, that is going to be removed. Now the it was removed, now you go for this record and try to insert a record. Enter 1, 2 is the roll number. Let me give it as current and I'll give it as 156. 156 as per the norms, it is not allowed, right? But I have removed the rule. When I have removed the rule, it should be acceptable. FI you give it, C1 row effective. That means rule is removed. That's the reason it is relaxation is there. Any value related to small int is allowed. So 156 it is taking. You can bind the rule and you can remove the rule from a column. While binding the rule, what rule to be bound to which column along with the table name to be given. While unbinding the rule from which column of which table to be specified, but what rule you should not say. Whatever rule is applied on that column, that is going to be removed. We have more than one rule. No. You will not have more than one rule on that. We don't have such type of facility first. Then what is the question of if two rules are bound, how do we remove only one rule? We can bind it. Okay. You are so sharp. But whatever rules are there, all will be removed. Specifically, a specific rule unbinding is not possible. Okay, Govind, good question, but I thought that somebody will ask this question, but my dear Govind asked. So very good. So that's about rules. Now, creation of user-defined data type. User-defined data type means what, madam? Is int, float, small int. Please explain the rule and unbind once again, please. Explain the rule again, or just unbinding the rule you are asking. Rule, I understood, Simran. Simran, rule meaning understood. You will create one condition. Where is my dear Simran? Oh great, after so long time I am looking at your face. Everybody say hi to everyone.
Hi,
She
ma'am.
said hi not only to me, to all. Okay?
Hi.
Now, you should unmute your mic.
Yeah.
Unmute your mic, my dear.
So. Unmute the mic.
100% both the roles will be there, Dudane Kumar, no two doubts. Simran, now you are a dumb.
Yeah, hello ma'am.
Only your co-friends can hear you, but not we can't hear you. So, first of all, what is a rule you understood? A rule means a condition I'm creating. The same condition is required on multiple columns of multiple tables. But I don't want to create multiple types. So create one as a rule. And link this rule to your columns of a table. Any table, any column I can link. That is with sp underscore bind rule. Sp underscore bind rule time two arguments. First one is which rule to be bound, to which table, which column to be bound with a comma separation you need to give. While after binding a rule to a column, now this rule must be followed by this column. It will not allow the values which violate this rule. Okay. So I have done. So if I'm giving 156, it's not taking because rule is 0 to 150 for math. So it was not taken previously. But what I have done afterwards, I am removing the rule from your math column of enter one. That is unbinding. That means whatever I have attached, I'm removing the rule. Now the column is what data type? Small int. If data type is small int, previously attached the rule, so small int rule as well as this rule also we should follow. But I am removing this rule from the column. When I am removing the call, this is only having small int data type, only that rule. So if I am giving 156, it is the rule to take. Rule I remove, so no rules, only data type 1. So it is accepted, this got inserted. Do you want to see the records in this table, enter 1? See here. Both the records are there. One is I have added before after adding attaching the rule. Second one is after removing the rule. That's why I can't give even 156, which is out of the range of rule, because I removed the rule. Once I unbound the rule, now it doesn't have any rules and regulations. It can take as per the small int any number it can take. Okay, so that's about rules. Okay, good. But with Mooki also we finished your doubt. Great. So new learning technique. Neha. My dear, specifically removing a specific rule from a column is not possible, my dear. Whatever rules are applied on a column, all must be removed at a time with sp underscore bind rule. Sp underscore bind rule does not help you to tell that only this rule you remove from the column. From which column rules to be removed, it will tell. But all the rules which are there on the column will be removed. Specially one rule to remove is not there. Okay? Now, Dudane Kumar, is your doubt clear? Both the records are there. Kumar, from Pune, Deccan. Neha, you did not respond, my dear. Drop rule is rule dropping, but you are not detaching. See here, rule is available, but not attached to your column if you unbind the rule. But rule is existing. Now I can use this rule on any column of any table. But if you drop the rule, it rule itself is not there. So how do you bind it to any column of any table? Just you are detaching using unbind. But rule is available. So I can use it on another column later. Dropping is completely you are removing. So nobody can use it. It is not there in your database anymore. 100% Govind, constraint also, alter command is there, alter table name, drop constraint name. Finish. Alter table name, drop constraint name. Then that particular constraint will be dropped. Okay? So good. So now what is the one? User defined data types creation. First of all, what do you mean by user defined data type? I'll just give you a small idea. I am creating one table, create, okay, student, and when I am creating this table, I found most of the places some data type is same, student, okay, in this one, roll number, age, primary key, well and good, then name, think of that first name, middle name, last name, first name. For this where care of 30 normal last name middle name all are mandatory think so that where care of 30 normal and last name where care of 30 normal okay then email ID where care of 30 normal So like that certain rules I want to apply and most of the columns what is the one data type you did not use the word table oh you are all right I'm really sorry small mistakes I'm doing Govind thank you so much my dear thank you so much okay so what you have observed in most of the columns first name middle name I have a data type where there 30 not null also Constraint also same, normal constraint, data type also same with the size 30 only. So I feel that if, what is there any methodology, shortcut methodology, instead of writing this much, I can use a shortcut. Why can't you do it? That is what user defined data type. For this data type or normal together, we are giving a shortcut name that is user defined data type. Okay. So here what I'm doing is create a type, user defined type. VC1 and VCNN, some name you give it, where care of not null, any name, okay, from, here not as, from, where care of 30, not null, so this is after from whatever you are giving, for the shortcut is VCNN, so let me select this one and press F5, so is it going to be created, VCNN, is completed successfully, So if it is done like this, wherever you want to write where care of this one, this is nothing, you don't need to write this much. You just write VCNN, enough. Are you understanding? This is how shortcut you see. VC, enough. VCNN. So VCNN is already you created a data type we as a shortcut for this. So VCNN, so not only in one table, in any table, wherever you want where care of 30 normal, you can use this shortcut name. So that it becomes easier for us. Okay. So now you see how easy it is while creating the table. Wherever you are expecting not null, where care of 30 not null you want to give. Instead of writing completely, I can use this user defined data type name. Now you select and press F5 table gets created or not. This is only user defined integrity also. Whatever this are. And remember, sorry, this is not user defined. What is your rules you created previously and applied it on your columns, that is user defined integrity. So this is user defined data type creation is clear. Size of data type. Yes, my dear. That means every time you are using VCNN, it is varchar of 30 only. I want 50 means you need to write varchar of 50 directly, but you cannot use VCNN. Otherwise, you create one more shortcut, VCNN one. VCNN 30 you create once, VCNN 50 you create. While you are creating that, you give the size of 50. That's 100 times I said it can be used for any table. Not only student table. Who said to student table? While creating the user defined data type, did I say that it can be only used from the student table? No. Any table, no one would you create, wherever you want varchar 30, varchar of 30 not null, you use VCNN in this database. User defined data type, it's a shortcut, Rashmi. Nothing is there in this. User defined data type is nothing but, wherever you want to write varchar 30 not null, for that a shortcut I am creating as a new data type. I am creating a new data type named as VCNN, which is nothing but is a shortcut for your data type where 30 not null. So I have created, this is the shortcut name, this is the new data type. It's a new data type you created. And it's nothing but varchar 30, not null. So whenever you are creating, wherever you want to write varchar 30 of not null, you can directly use that user defined data type name. Are you understanding? Can we do the same with, why not? Simran, I never said that it is only with varchar. It can be with any data type, daytime data type. And not only daytime data type, condition also you write, constraint name. That means the date of joining, that should be less than or equal to, value should be less than or equal to, get date, or like that, rules also you write. So including rules, you are wherever same rules, if you want, you can directly use it. Clear? It's not only for varchar, it can be for any data type. Shabbat, that's what my dear, I can create a new data type. See here, create type, okay, int pk from int primary key, you take it. Sorry, primary key spelling wrong, y is missing. You select it and press F5, somewhere. Let me read. Wi-Fi primary key is not giving. Wi-Fi unique, it is not allowing. And let me just check. Not allowing unique, only not null it is allowing. I'll just check what it, but on integer 100% you can do. See, select like this. So what you understood here? SP underscore help student. Why not? Ratan, you're so great. SP underscore help. Structure of the student class table he is asking to show. So structure you can see. What is there, my dear? VCNN. What is VCNN? This question you will get in your cycle test. Like this, he will create one any table creation he will write, but he will write a data type user defined name, but not predefined int float like that. He will not be something he will give. So what this represents, he'll ask. So simply, bluntly, you need to say it's a user defined data type. That's it. What is VCNN here means? Directly you will tell what? It's a user defined data type. Is it clear, Ratan? Any data type name you can use. Can you? No. Data type name only. You cannot give. Only for data types it's a shortcut. It's not for order by. Are you talking about select statements? No, not at all. It's a data type shortcut. User defined data type syntax creation. How simple is it? Create type new data type name followed by from is the keyword. That means after from, whatever you are giving for this entire one, this is the shortcut name. That's a new data type. So wherever this you want to write, there you should use VCNN. Rashmi, clear? Not Rashmi. Divya. Divya, clear? Rikvika, I scrolled up, my dear. I am showing you that syntax only, na? This is user-defined data type creation. This is only user-defined data type creation. This is one user-defined data type creation. This is another user-defined data type creation. That's what? It is giving error, no, my dear, you have seen. I said that I will check once again and I'll let you know. So some error it is giving, it is not allowing the constraints names unique like that except not null. other constraints means it is not allowing. I'll just check why, what is the error we are doing. The syntax I'll see and tell you in the next class. Don't worry for that. It is only shortcut to data types, not shortcut to anything else. Chetan. Only for data type, not for anything. Chetan clear, Pune Deccan. Go be in the primary key constraint the next class only because I have to check. I think Simran doubt cleared, it can be used even on integer also. Okay, good. So now you have seen user defined data type also. There are two more topics in this chapter. What are the two more topics? It means synonyms. So synonyms, when I want to tell, let me take another database, NITDB. In my computer, I have another database. NITDB, so let me go to that database. I just want to go to that database, NITDB. Let me hide my video so you can see at the top that you have opened NITDB. Okay, what happened? 1 minute. Okay, so now it is done successfully. See, NITDB database is open. Being in NIT database, everybody, you write your opinion. Being in NIT database, can I see the human resources.employee table of AdventureWorks database? AdventureWorks database is different, NITDB database is different. Am I able to see the records of a table of another database being in NITDB? Is it possible or not? Yes means Y, no means N. Rahul said no. Others also please respond. Correct or wrong doesn't matter, but you try. Rudranan said that no, Ratan said no, Ritvika said no, Abhishek from Ashiba yes, Raghav no, and Supriya no, Dudhane Kumar yes, Divya no, Simran no, and other students, Shabaz, everybody also said no. But notes, all notes are wrong, all yeses are correct. Only two students, Abhishek and Dudhane Kumar are correct, I can. But only the thing is, the problem is what must select star from when I'm writing including database name, I need to write AdventureWorks dot human resources dot employee. But this much full I have to write. Okay? So being in NITDB, if you want to access a particular table or table from another database, so most of the times I want to refer this table being in NITDB database, then I'm feeling tough to write, I'm feeling the time waste, this much writing is memory waste. I feel like that. So is there any methodology? Being in NITDB, easily I can refer this without mentioning this entire one. So shortcut for this also is possible, that is synonym. Synonym is what? It's nothing but the same table. It will not create any new table. It's like for this entire name, a synonym name you are creating so that with that synonym you can refer from your NITDB. So how you can do it? You know, simple. Being in NITDB only. Create synonym. Okay. Synonym name is what? Okay, synonym name is ADV EMP. Employee ADV. AE, I am giving as AHE, AdventureWorks, Human Resources, Employee, something I have given as is it correct? I think, let me check the syntax once, I have done it already, synonym, I think I haven't done, let me check. For, there is a short, what I have to use? For, not as, for. For, what is the, for which it is shortcut? For this entire, one you give it as shortcut. Okay, and select base and press F7. It is not mean that a new table you are creating, it's just a different name to refer to this table from your array shortcut name you to refer to this. That is called as a synonym. Okay, so now select star from AHE. If you give like that, it's nothing but see here. It's a shortcut synonym, but it does not mean that this table is there in your NITDB. This is nothing but you are referring from AdventureWorks human resources.employee table itself being in NITDB. So I'm just creating a shortcut as a synonym. And you can drop the synonyms, drop synonym, synonym name, and alter the synonyms, alter synonym, synonym for a new synonym one. That is your, that you can check from your book, each and everything not required. Drop synonym, synonym, AHE also, no need to write. That you please check. Dropping the synonym, dropping the table, drop table, table name. Synonyms dropping, drop synonym, synonym name. So is it clear? Srinivas said that, yes, so he said, Cyril, I can't be able to retrieve the column given name like SQL keywords like group. Column, how can I retrieve that? Oh God, let me check, Chetan. I really did not understand. I'm trying to connect to you. Please tell me what is your doubt. I will try to help you. Chetan? Chetan, you wrote a very big sentence. Tell me. Man, actually, I can't able to retrieve the column given name, like SQL keywords, like a group column. How can you retrieve that column? I did not get. Tell me. Unmute your mic, my dear. First work is unmute your mic.
Hello? Hello?
Hello, I am telling, not you. You are not audible, but I am audible to you. Lip movement, I don't know. That knowledge, I don't have.
Hello, am I audible, ma'am? Hello.
Tell keywords like that, I really did not understand.
Hello. Hello.
What? Hello. Disconnecting right here. Otherwise our time is directing. So now very important topic, and before that I want everybody to confirm with me, is it clear or not? Let me write a feedback question. Synonyms is clear or not? Did you understand? Synonyms, tables, user defined, data types. Yes, no. Very fast this time. Very few. Rohit, Anil from Pune Deccan, Saurabh, Sanjay from Pune Deccan. There is one guest ID, center name is also guest, so I cannot predict. Oh, that student has given. Pune Deccan, Rohit, Shabaz from Southex, Saunak from Gariahat, Syed Mohammed from Faridabad sector, 4 students, 1 minute. 1 student more given, Syed, Saunak and Shabaz. What is the problem? Why you did not respond? only two. That means slowly might be question is displayed for you. Syed Mohammed, Saunak Ghosh. Saunak Ghosh from Gariahat. Syed from Faridabad sector. These two students did not respond. Rest of all the students respond. Faridabad sector, other students please write in the hand raise about Syed, whether he is available right now or not. And about Saunak, Gariahat students are going to confirm with me whether the student is available or not, because these two students did not respond for the question. Oh God, you can hear him, Neha. Okay, once again I'll try to connect to this student. Just wait. You all are saying that you can hear him, right? Let me connect once again to this student. Chetan, right? Chetan, please raise your hand once again. Okay, Cyril, but whether he understood or not, please write, my dear. Saunak Ghosh available, yes, but understood or not, you need to write. No, Saunak. Where is my dear? Who is having the doubt? Means I connected, but I disconnected, right? That student, please hand raise once again. Chetan, there is empty hand raise you give it. I'll try to connect to you, and whether you are audible or not, I'll check. What happened? Chetan felt bad and he left. What happened to you? Give empty hand raise means you are not giving. Now you speak.
No, ma'am. Yes, am I audible, ma'am?
Others, please respond. Might be there is a problem from my end. So, others, please respond. Can you hear him? Crystal clear. Very nice words, actually. You speak. He is audible. Others are saying. 1 minute.
Hello.
Then from... Just wait, might be problem from my end, I will just check. Because others are saying that you are audible to them. You are not audible to me only. He's speaking, others are able to hear him. Now you speak. Say hello.
Hello. Hello, ma'am.
Good. Good. Now you are audible. Now, good. So that means problem from my end. Well, now you tell me what is your doubt.
Okay. Let's suppose, ma'am, if we give the column name as SQL keywords like group or order, so how can we retrieve that column?
Do you mean like this? Select 1 minute. Any group type statement can I write?
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Like
group. Okay. Sum of salary from NITDB. Let me connect it to our Adventure Works database, okay? Because we don't have the required columns in that. From EMP professional 1. So, are you talking? EMP, PRO, FESSI, ONAL, 1. How
no, ma'am.
Table?
Just select group from EMP professional. So, group is a column name from
group.
EMP professional table 1.
Select
yes.
Group.
Group, yes. So it
column name cannot be given as group because it's a keyword.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, but how can we retrieve that
Ah,
column?
how can you give? You want to give the column name as select. You want to give the column name as from, it is not possible. Keywords are not allowed as columns names, okay?
Okay.
Are you getting my point? There is no table having the column name with the keywords name. I can't give a column name as group because it's a keyword. What's my point? What I'm trying to say?
Yes.
So we'll do one thing. Okay. You mean that create a table, XSX, waste table I'm creating. I'll give the column name as group int. Okay. Let me create a table. Is it creating, my dear? Column name, group means, is it creating?
No, ma'am.
We give it as from. It's also a keyword, right? Can we give the column name as from? You check it. From is a
no.
keyword. So when you are unable to give, what is the question of retrieval? So that is your question. So your question is resolved. Now, okay. Yes, my dear, my side only problem, I cleared Dudane Kumar. You both are audible to me, Shubham. Good, good, good. Okay, finally the problem resolved, even I can hear him. So completed doubt clearance, the last topic of fourth chapter, which is very much, very, very important. And if you are using SQL Server, like standard edition or trial editions like that, this demo will not work. It works only in enterprise edition of SQL Server. In SQL Server only, different editions, enterprise edition, developers edition, standard edition, trial edition, like that many will be there. Generally, people will install standard edition. In the standard edition SQL Server, whatever I am going to teach that topic, you cannot do those examples in your computer. It works only, what is the minimum requirement, it can be executable only from enterprise edition of your SQL Server. Mine is enterprise edition, so it will work. So what is this? First, partitioned tables creation. What is partitioned tables? Let us get the data from one of the students, we'll connect and we'll try to that. Use of that will try to identify. So the student must be very active. One student who is very active, we will take that student, Bal Mukund. Mukund, it's your time. So between you and me, whatever discussion is happening, from there the meaning, the purpose of partition tables needs to be understood by all. Okay? So valuable discussion will be. So now I am telling you, there is a textbook for me. In the textbook, around 12 chapters are there. How many? 12 chapters are there in that book. That is one textbook only with 12 chapters.
Ma'am, I'm not getting your voice. Hello? Hello?
Am I not audible to you?
Yes, ma'am. I'm not getting your voice. Is breaking.
My voice. Others, please respond. Am
Hello?
I audible to you? Clear? Others, please respond, my dear. In a hand raise.
Your voice is coming, but it's breaking.
Yes, Aditya, your doubt also I'll clear. 1 minute. Others, please, you are both are audible. Clear, others are saying that I'm clear. Everybody is saying that I'm clear. Okay, okay. So there is a problem, so let me connect you to my dear Aditya. Aditya, now I'll connect it to you, my dear. Yesterday you asked me one question, I remember. I just kept the answer also, but that day, yesterday time is over, right? So, hi Aditya, adjust your camera. Am I talking to Aditya? Adjust your camera. Adjust little, you need to more adjust. I can see you only your forehead. adjust your camera. Time is getting wasted, my dear. The people are not understanding how to adjust the camera. Okay, okay, good. Last test, it's you who asked me the question how to add the column in between two existing columns. It is not possible. Whenever you are adding using alter statement only, it gets added at the last only. It cannot be added in between the existing two columns. Always it will be added at the end of the existing column. Mm-hmm. Is about clear?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Good. Now you can speak, say hello.
Hello.
That means you are
hello.
Audible. Now we'll do. You are audible. Mm-hmm. I understood. My testing is over. So we'll start our work. So what I am trying to say, there is one book in the library, but only one copy of the book is there, which has 12 chapters. That book. You are from which center?
Kothrud, Pune.
Pune. Kothrud, Pune. Okay, okay. Okay. Now listen. 12 chapters are there in that book. And book is a single book. And there is no one more copy of that book in the library. Very important topics are there in that book. So I went to the library, I have taken that book for learning and I am reading the second chapter. Okay? Second chapter I am reading. Meanwhile, what was happened is some other student also came to the library for learning from the same book, but they want to learn eighth chapter. Is it possible we both can read at the same time? Only one book is available in the, video starts, so I am disconnecting. Others are trying to understand what is the problem here. I have only one book where all the 12 chapters are there, whereas I have already taken that book and learning the second chapter, whereas another person has come for the same book, they want to learn each chapter, whereas it is not possible. So what has to be done? They need to wait till the time I have to learn and keep the book there, then they can take it. At the same time, when they are learning, somebody else is coming, might be. They want to learn fifth chapter. Again, it's a problem. So what I need to, it does not mean that it's a two different books. A single book can also be accessed first chapter. Everybody is learning different chapters. But book is only one. So what we can do, you know, one book can be splitted into small parts. First chapter, you tear it and make it as one part. Second chapter, you tear it and make it as one part. Book same, but I should call it as single book, but I'll make it as multiple partitions. First partition in the rack 1, second partition in the rack 2, third partition in the rack 3. Like that, 5 partitions I have done it into. First 2 chapters, I'm breaking first 2 chapters and keeping in the first rack. Third and fourth chapters, I'm breaking and keeping in the second rack. Fifth and sixth, I'm breaking and keeping in the third rack. Like that, two chapters wise, I'm splitting that single file into multiple files and keeping in different racks. So if I'm coming and I want to learn second chapter, I'll go to the first rack and take that where first and second chapters are there. Meanwhile, somebody else is coming and they want to learn eighth chapter, they will go to fourth rack where seventh and eighth chapters are data is available. They will take. So they don't require to wait till the time till I am just learning my topic. They can simultaneously take, and somebody else is coming, they want fourth chapter, they will take it. So what's happening? So the work is simultaneously different parts of your, single textbook is available to multiple people to access. So that is called as partitioning. Like that, single table, keep it in your brain, single table, can be made, but records of the single table can be maintained in multiple files. One file might be in one file group, second file might be in second file group, third file might be in third file group, fourth file in fourth file group. There are four file groups. Files I'm maintaining for a single table. But some records of the table I'm placing in the first a file which is in the file group 1. Some more records of the same table, I'm not placing all the records at one place. and spreading the records into four different files to four different file groups. So what's happening? Physically they are available at different locations. Single table but with multiple physical files spread in different places. So one student is trying to access record which is in the first physical file name. So let them read. Meanwhile, other person can come and refer the records which are in the other partitions. So they are not required to wait till the time the first person completes the work with the first part. So what happens? The performance gets increased. The performance of data retrieval becomes increased. Simultaneously, many of the people can access many records from different files of the same table. Are you understanding? Think so that in my computer, in my table employees, employees table, I have salary column also, you feel so. I have four files in four different file groups. File group means class and metal. A file group is a collection of files. I have created four files. I have created file groups four. First file, I kept it in first file group. Second file, I kept in second file group. Like that, I have done. Four file groups are there. Now what I want to do, I want to create a single partitioned table. Partitioned table means what, madam? While creating the table, I should tell that don't create it as if it is a, it is to be created as a single file. Instead, the records of this table to be distributed into four files that we have created. But which record should go to the first file? Which record should go to the second file? Like that, if you talk about. Based on the salary column value entered by the user, if it is less than 30,000, if it is less than 30,000, all the records whose salary column value is less than 30,000 should go to the first file group file. And in case you are giving your salary, new employee details, where salary you are giving greater than or equal to 30,000 but less than 40,000, less than 40,000. Greater than or equal to 30,000 and less than, that means 30,000 to 39,999 still there. Whatever salary fee enter, that record should be distributed into the second file group. And at the same time, 40,000 to 50,000, less than 50,000 should go to third, or 50 or above 50 should go to the fourth file group. So salary wise I am doing. Why this salary wise I am doing is, feel, use your brain, why this is partitioning. Sometimes you will write select star from table name, okay, where salary greater than or equal to 60,000. So if I write like that, just think, what really, if it is not a partition table, all the records are maintained in a single file, so that I have to go to that file. If 1 crore records are there, you think so. But among these 1 crore records, where records with salary greater than or equal to 60,000, I don't know. So what it will do? First record, it will go and check. Is the salary is greater than or equal to 60,000? If not so, it will not display and go and check the same type of testing with second record, third record till 1 crore records. So out of which only 5 records are there, you think so, which are greater than or equal to 60,000. So, but comparisons, how many you have done? 1 crore comparisons, 1 crore records comparisons for salary you have checked, but 5 only satisfied that you displayed. But it takes time or not. Instead of that, what I have done, partition table, while creating table as partition table, and I said that less than 30,000 in the first file group, second 30,000 to less than 40, second file group, like that, if you distribute it, and you are given this query, what happens? It knows that it is a partitioned table based on the salary column, based on salary column value. Based on salary column value only partition, so that, 60,000, it should be in which file? Fourth file. So it never touches first file, second file, third file of file group. Last file group, directly it will go and there only it will fetch the records which are available in that for salary greater than or equal to 60,000. It never fetches in the file, first group. Why? Because 100% I know that only salary less than 30,000 it will hold. Second one will hold less than 40,000. Third one will hold less than 50,000. And last group only 50 or above 50. So my 60,000 will lie in that. If I'm giving somewhere 35,000, where I will search? I'll not search in first, but I'll search in second. I will not touch in fourth or fifth, because 35,000, 100% will be available in only second file group. So I'm skipping testing of all the records I'm not doing. Only one file, second file group place only I'm going and testing. So much time you are saving. That will improve the performance. This type of partition tables to be created on which column, madam, is in where condition, most of the times on which, based on which column value you are filtering. Based on which column value, most of the times you are filtering and getting on that column partition tables to be created. Based on that column partition tables to be created. So are you thinking so that you created on salary, but you are not checking on salary, you are checking based on some designation is equal to clerk. Do you think so that this partition table will help you? You have not partitioned based on your designation, you have partitioned based on your salary. So I don't know where clerk will be there, where in first or second, third or fourth. Salary wise means I can tell, because I have partitioned like that. So again, all the four files or groups it will enter and search and it will do it. So only partitioned table, whatever you create based on what column you have created, on that column only if you are giving where condition, that partitioned tables will help you out to make your searching faster. Is the purpose clear to all of you? Tell me, is the purpose clear? Let me check your hand raises. Yes, ma'am, clear, clear, everything is clear, ma'am. Give the synonym for schema. Schema like that you don't give, my dear, only for tables. We cannot give for specific schema, okay? Clear, clear. Will name only just I wrote, spell mistake also what is just the syntax I wrote. Sripati. Somebody is saying scanning is done. Scanning. Okay, till now I got the messages as clear. So let me move ahead. So how to create? Remember, you did not create the table, you want to create the partition table. So if you want to create a partition table, there are three steps you need to follow. Partition table, directly create table, and not like that. Before to that, creating the partition table, two extra works, that means three, on the whole three works. That is what, there are three steps are there, three steps to create the partition table. Okay, the first one is what, step one, create a partition function. What is function? I'll tell. Don't worry. I'm going to tell you. Step two, create a partition scheme. Scheme, not schema. Scheme. So people will get confusion here also. Scheme is different. Schema is different. Don't compare with the same. Scheme is totally different. Okay. Create a partitioned table using partition scheme. And here also the scheme can be created based on using partition function. The first partition function that represents. So actually what is my work? What is this partition function? No. To specify how the data partitions to be done. Data partitions means what I told, less than 30,000 one group and 30,000 to less than 40,000 one group, like that ranges of groups. That means which range should go to one group, which ranges to be created, just ranges. Okay, so this how to specify the data partitions to be done, which range should be first partition. So range of values of each partition. So forget about what table you are creating. How you can create, bluntly I'm telling, based on which column, in our sense, employee table I want to create as a partitioned table. Based on its salary, records to be distributed into multiple files. So keep it in your brain, before you go for all these three sets, first work is you should create four file groups and four files. These four files are to be placed in that file groups. You create four file groups, four files. Attach first file to first group, second file to second group. That is compulsory. That is afterwards file, right? That is very simple, 2 minutes work. Okay? And how you can create a partition? Create a partition function. What is partition function name? My salfunc. I just gave the name as salfunc. Okay? Add range right here. Is it correct? For range, I think. For range, right. For, I'll just check the syntax. Might be small mistakes. Create partition function name. For range. For of range, I'll just check. For range, right from. Create partition function serves for small, few seconds please. I'm thinking that I'm giving some mistake in the syntax. I did a small mistake, nothing else. Syntactically, it's only syntax. How much time is taking? It's a 5 to 10 minutes only it will take. Only thing is syntax, I did a mistake. Forgot. Any mistake means again, it's a very big problem. So, that will give the syntax. See here, create partition function name. Partition function name. Achha, first mistake is after partition function name, you want to spread based on salary column value. Salary generally what data type will give? All of you, right? I'll write as Sachin. 1 minute. Just tell me based on whose column values we want to partition salary. Generally we'll take it as money. That data type to be given. That data type to be given in the bracket, which I forgot. That's the first mistake. And now my as is correct only. I have done 100% correct, but the only mistake is this I did not. That's why it is saying that as is wrong. As range right for values. This is fixed. But here left means left can be written, right can be written. Right means what? Left means what? I'm going to tell you. I'll give everything here. What am I doing is 30,000, 40,000 and 50,000. If you give like that, how many values I have given in the bracket? Please count. How many values I have given in the bracket? How many values? Just tell me how many values I have given in the bracket. 3. But how many ranges are created? How many partitions will be created, you know? 4. 4 ranges are created. What are 4 ranges, madam? Is when you give right, so every range, whatever you are giving, from where range starts till where it stands is before to the end. Next range starts from 40,000. That means before value is what? 39,999 is the end of the first. So what I'll just give you. What are the different ranges are going to be created is 4 ranges, that means 4 partitions are created. What is the first partition? You know, less than 30,000 is the first partition. All the values which are less than 30,000 will be first partition. Second partition is starts from 30,000 to 39,999, that means less than 40,000. Next partition starts from 40,000. Next partition starts from 40,000 to 49,999, and next partition starts from 50,000 to and above. That means 50,000 and above means anything. So four partitions will happen if it is right. If it is left means what will happen if it is right? The same one I am just creating, but I will execute either one. Only for your knowledge I am writing. In place of this left, if I am writing, what happens? Here also four ranges, no two doubts at all. Okay? So what is the meaning? The left means whatever you are giving is the ending limit of your, that means the first range is what, no, my dear? Less than or equal to 30,000, including 30,000 is first. 30,000 or less than 30,000 is first. Second group is 30,001 to 40,000. That is the end limit. Okay. That means whatever you are giving will be the final value of that group, and its left side values will become as a starting values. But till where means after this value, 30,001 to 40,000 second group. Third group will be 40,001 to 50,000. Okay. And last group is above 50,000. All above 50,000. So what you understand, right means blunt. Whatever you are giving from that number onwards, right side the range stands. Right side range, that means this is the starting value of the range. Ending value will be one value before to the next value. This is the next range starting. This is the next range starting. Then end of this one is, its previous value is end of the first range. Its previous value of this is end of this range. So from here I will move to the right for getting the end value. But here what I am doing left means, this is the end value. Starting values, if you go to the left, you will get it. So this is the methodology. But we will use only one. Okay. So this I will just comment for you. I am just commenting just for your understanding I have written. So this just creates four partitions, four ranges. That must only remember. This partition function is creating four groups, four partitions just to create. So come out completed successfully. But do you have, is there any meaning I have created? But which range, before you are going to the next step, you should create four file groups, four files inside that file group. Then you please link these four partitions you created with partition function. Link the first partition to file group 1, link the second partition to file group 2, third partition to file group 3, fourth partition to file group 4. So that means what you have to do, four partitions, you have to, four file groups with minimum one file to be created. The number of files is great, but minimum one file should be there. How do you create file groups with one file? Before I am going to the second step, I have to show you how you can create a file groups. So go to your object view, object explorer, on your, adventure works database, because what we are doing is in adventure works. So go to adventure works, just right click on that, select properties. Right click on the database name where you want to create the file groups and files, properties. Then you will get one window where file groups one tab will be there. Files, here files is there, file groups also is there. Are you understanding? The first work is first to create file group, then create the files and put it in these file groups. By default system will create one file group, I said, that is the primary file group. Other than that, you create, click on add and give your own name, FG1, file GRP1, FGRP1 means file group 1, FGRP2, add SGRP3, add SGRP4. And all of you please observe number of files it is showing as 0, right? Why it is showing 0 means just now you created file groups, not even a single file you kept it in that group, so it is not showing any files in that file group. File groups creation is done. Now you go for files tab and click on add, create secondary files, then it is give it as file 1, and but where you want to put, not in the primary group, put it in the FGRP1. Under the file group FGRP1 you take it. First one is finished. Second one, file 2, and give the F, put it in file, minimum one file in each group. That's why I'm writing. File 3, you can go for linked, put it in that file group 3. File 4, put it in the group file 4. Now you just go to file groups for your clarity. See, now you see previously zeros it has stored, but now 1 because you have placed the 4 files, creation and kept. Now done. This is only simple way of creation file groups. File groups names are what? FGRP1, FGRP2, FGRP3, FGRP4. Now my work, one work is finished. Now we can close the browser, that is Object Explorer. The first step is done, my dears. What is the first step? Tell me. That is nothing but steps are there. First step is creation of the partition function, where ranges creation separation to be done. Now step 2, partition function creation, partition scheme. Scheme will attach, it binds the groups, groups means what? Partitions, okay, created by partition function to file groups, to your file groups. Okay, which range should connect to file group 1, which range should connect to file group 2. How simple is it? Create partition scheme. Partition scheme name, what will give, previously what we gave the name for this, my dear? Myself scheme I gave. And here, for is the one, for means I'm representing the name of the 1 minute, for is the correct partition scheme, as, not for, as, like previously as only, as partition, what is that, a partition function name, bro? Partition function, am I writing correct or directly partition function name, let me, as, I think somewhere I am giving some mistake, I'll just to all the file groups name FGRP1, FGRP2, FGRP3, FGRP4. What is the meaning of this is, there are some mistakes I have done. Let me check the scenario as partition is a word to be written. Okay. So here create partition scheme, scheme name, but scheme can be created to bind the ranges created by your partition function myself to the file groups. It is creating how many ranges, my dear? 4 ranges. So 4 ranges, the first 2 range of the records will go to the file of FGRP1. Second range files, that means less than 30,000 always will come here. 30,000 to 39,999 here. 40,000 to 49,999, 50,000 are above here. Okay, this is a partition scheme creation, select and press F5. So linking your partitions to the file groups are also done. Final step is partition table creation, very simple. See here, create a table, table's name is what, my dear? What will give? Employees, okay. I'm giving just to say very simple, same as like previously, EMPID it, but there is a rule that whenever you want to apply the partitions based on a column, salary column, it must be part of the primary key, or no primary key should, either no primary key should be there in your table, or your salary column must be part of the primary key, okay? So now So don't give this one as the primary key. EMP name, where care of 20. VCNN also you write. VCNN, you remember we created that. And what else? VCNN is showing wrong. We created in the what? NITDB, I think. Now, salary column, which is money, and money, and you just give it as not null. Even you can make this also that is not mandatory, okay? Not null. And designation, where care of 30. Okay, address, where care of 100. So enough if you feel. This is general table creation, but not partition. Only one extra is, at last, after closing the bracket, on, on. What is a partition scheme name? Scheme, not partition function. Scheme name, you give it. You give the scheme name. And in the bracket, based on which column values you want to partition, salary column value of your table. So write this. So it means that based on the values of salary column, partitioned table to be created. Partitions are linked to which partitions means that is partition function, and those partitions are linked to which file groups already there in your file scheme name. Scheme is representing which partitions to be connected to which file groups. Partitions creation is done by the function. Now using that scheme I am creating, that means based on salary column values, the first range of values is at less than 30,000. If you give less than 30,000, it should go to the first partition, and 30,000 to 39,999 should go to the second one, like that. So now this is called as a partition table creation, where on scheme name, this is scheme name followed by, madam, where is function name? Why do you want? Scheme is already created based on function. So that knows already, if you refer that, this automatically refers to a partition function. So now you press F5, so that partition table is going to be created. If you don't use partition scheme and create, it's a normal table. The table records are not spread into multiple files. They will be maintained in a single file. Is that clear? This is executing in my system, might not be executed in your machine. For what reason? Same as it is, how you have, we are giving, madam. Might be yours is not enterprise edition. I said that it should be enterprise, it must be enterprise edition, then only this part. See here, partition function, when you create a or partition scheme, it will give nicely error get down. It will work only in enterprise edition. This is standard edition, it will not work. That message also it will give, so you will not get confused. So syntactically, your command might be correct, it may not execute in your machine if you have the standard edition. But at least minimum meaning you should understand, so I have given. Okay? Practically you may not be able to do if your center is providing this, because center doesn't have the permission. None of it, even me also don't have the permission to have the enterprise edition. But because I need to show you, I have taken the special permission, because enterprise edition is not allowed to be used by education department. Only very big industries are only allowed to use the enterprise edition. Because I need to show this demo, means I should have it, so I have installed. So this is the end of the fourth chapter. Any doubts? Partition table, anybody is first partition function. Can you please show it once? Partition table. Physically you can't see, internally. Now after creating, just I'm telling you, insert into Dudhani Kumar. I can't see external, I cannot show that there are three partitions like that, four partitions. Internal it happens. Insert into employees, okay, values. 1 minute, let me check the column since I forgot actually. It is an empty table, I know. Just for columns list, okay. I'm giving one, okay. Ganesh, salary 34,000, and designation director, address here. If I give like that, what happens, madam? This record goes to your table, but your table is a distributed, records are distributed into four files. Into which file group, which file means second file group, because 34,000 belongs to the second range. So it goes to file group 2 file, okay? Internally you don't, internally it happens, externally you can't see it. Right and left again goes in. Why not? So Govind is asking right and left to explain again. I will just give you 2 minutes of time. Let me check. No doubt, no doubt. Anybody is having any more doubts, I'm checking. Less than, that's what, not Rohit. Rohit, what you understood, my dear? If I'm giving 24,000, it goes to the first group. If I'm giving 24,000, it goes to the... It is indirectly went to the first group, because 30,000, 40,000, now somebody is asking you me questions. Let me write in this left here, left range if you are using, range left, okay? Left left if you use while you are writing, and you have given the ranges 30,000, sorry, 10,000, okay, 20,000, 30,000, 40,000, 4 values you gave, you think so. How 4 values means ranges are 5. How many ranges, my dear? 5. And left means what, you know? Left means always keep it. This value is the first range. Whatever values you are seeing are the range means x to y values are, x to y means one range. Y is the value. This is right end. Left means what? The range is to the left side of this value. That means less than or equal to 10,000 till any value less than 10,000 and equal to 10,000 will be the first range. Okay, this is the first range. Second range is what, my dear? Less than, greater than 10,000, that is 1,000. Instead of that, 10,000, I can say like that, greater than 10,000. And less than or equal to 20,000 is second range. That means always you see, this is the end place. Left means from its left, its range is to the left of its this value. Whatever you specified, its range to its left. From where it starts means after the value of the previous end range. So it was ended here means next greater than 10,000 till 20,000 is the second. Third one is what? Greater than 20,000 and less than or equal to 30,000. Third. And greater than 30,000 and less than or equal to 40,000. And what is the fifth? Greater than 40,000 all comes under the fifth range. That is for left. Same you are giving with right. The values as 10,000, 20,000, 30,000, 40,000. Now I am telling blunt, okay, range 1. Range 1 I am telling, always less than 10,000. All values less than, not including 10,000. Less than 10,000. All the values below to the first value, below to the first value, not even including first value. So that is the first range. Second range is what, my dear? Range 2 will be 10,000 onwards, whatever number is specified from there onwards, less than next value. Less than next value means and less than 20,000 you can write easily. Okay. From 10,000 till less than 20,000. Less than 20,000. Range 3, 20,000 onwards it starts and ends by less than 30,000, because next range starts from 30,000. 30,000 and less than 40,000. Range 5. So 40,000 and above. Okay. So that is the right means. Right means what, you know, whatever value is there, that is the left side limit. Range moves from that number to the right side. So every range you see here, starting with this value, every whatever values you get, that is the starting values of the ranges, and range is moving to the right. That's the range is moving to the right means right. But what are the values less than 10,000? That is one group. Now is it clear? Govind? Correct or no, my dear? Right means from whatever number you have given, that is the starting value of the range, and range moves to the right till the previous value of the next range starting value. This is the starting of first one range, this is starting of another range, or starting of one range, starting of one range, and what is the ending is before to the one value before to the ending starting value of next range. Simran, clear? Simran, is it clear? This also in your notes, I will keep it so that it will be more easier for you to understand. Just as I say like that, you just understand, you can understand. Here only, whatever script I have given, first let me save our script. Script I pasted here. These are the notes which I am going to post in your group. Everybody do the practice after completion of this, after ending this, after giving feedback, go and do your task. Okay. Might be two more batch codes are 265, 299, don't feel bad. Just for my clarity, I'm keeping like that. So this is the file, I'll put it in your group. Now you give your feedback. Meanwhile, I'll put this file in your group. Okay? It's time for what? Feedback. Feedback.